Innovation is the cornerstone of success in America. In order to compete in the global marketplace, businesses and individuals are continuously striving to stay ahead of the game. I'm Terry Bradshaw. You know, from emerging technologies and financial strategies to the latest healthcare developments, you would be surprised by the many factors coming into play. Welcome to Today in America. Some of the most exciting research in the world is happening in the field of medicine. Medical breakthroughs have the potential to save countless lives and provide hope in times of crisis. Let's explore one promising example.
Nearly 5.8 million Americans suffer from heart failure, a long-term chronic problem that, according to the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute, contributes to 300,000 deaths each year.
Heart failure is when your heart becomes weak, and there's a number of things that can cause your heart to become weak, such as a heart attack. It can become a little bit weak, and you can do pretty much whatever you want still with some symptoms, or it can become really weak, where your heart is not able to pump enough blood to even meet the needs of your body, and then you can get in a really bad, even a life-threatening situation with heart failure.
While heart transplantation is the best surgical treatment for suitable patients with end-stage heart failure, there are a limited number of donor hearts available. Over the years, scientists have developed a variety of other ways to optimally support failing hearts and thereby improve and, in many cases, extend patient lives. One device offering realistic hope to patients with end-stage heart failure is known as a left ventricular assist device, first developed in the 1960s.
So the left ventricular assist device is a pump that takes over the pumping function of a weak heart. We put it in with a big operation, but we take blood from the weak left ventricle into the pump, out to the aorta, and to the rest of the body. The pumps now are so good, so sophisticated, that they can keep patients alive for years and also provide patients with a really good quality of life.
Evahart Medical USA, a venture by Japanese company Sun Medical Technology Research Corporation, is one of several organizations working diligently to improve the technology.
Some of the challenges in our industry include designing a patient-friendly system that will run for years without stopping, avoiding complications such as bleeding, infection, and stroke that were encountered by previous iterations of ventricular assist devices. The Evahart blood pump is a centrifugal pump and by design does not produce any noticeable noise. It is roughly the size of a tennis ball and is made of pure titanium.
The system was conceived at Tokyo Women's Medical University by cardiothoracic surgeon Dr. Kenji Yamazaki and developed by Sun Medical Technology Research Corporation.
The first in-human use of the Evahart left ventricular assist system occurred at Tokyo Women's Medical University Hospital in May 2005. Sun Medical completed the 18-patient trial in 2008 and is working with the Japanese Pharmaceutical and Medical Device Agency to gain commercial approval in Japan.
In the Japanese clinical trial, most patients were supported by the device for more than 2 years while they awaited a heart transplant. As of September 2010, this device had accumulated more than 45 years of patient support, while for the first patient, he was on the same blood pump, running continuously for 5 years without a failure. The durability test systems simulate the flows and pressures of a heart failure patient while monitoring the performance of the Evahart system. The purpose of the test is to look for failures and to demonstrate durability. We've never seen a blood pump fail in any of these tests or the Japanese clinical trial.
The success of the system in the lab and the Japanese clinical trial has led the company to enroll the device in a U.S. clinical trial for use as a bridge to cardiac transplantation in candidates accepted for cardiac transplant.
Our bridge to transplant trial is planned for 147 patients at up to 40 U.S. clinical sites. Patients who meet the entry criteria and agree to participate will receive the device and will be monitored for 6 months or until they receive a heart transplant.
With 670,000 new heart failure cases diagnosed every year, company officials hope their technology will enable them to play a key role in the future of ventricular assist devices.
As the elderly population increases, the number of potential patients for our device will also increase. Due to the expense and the clinical trial results, only a few ventricular assist device companies may last into the future. Our goal is to use our current and developing technology to improve the survival of heart failure patients with ventricular assist device.